years ends, the age of Jacob will be 3 times that of his son. 5 years ago, Jacob's age was 7 times that of his son. What are their present ages? I want you to pause this video and think on your own to solve this problem. Let me write this information in the form of equation. For that, I will set variables for the unknown quantities. That is, what are their present ages? We don't know the Jacob's present age and his son's present age. So for that, I will consider Jacob's present age as Jacob's present age be 8 years. We don't know this. For that, I have taken Jacob's present age as 8 years. Next unknown quantity is Jacob's son's age. That is Jacob's son's present age be 8 years. Let his son's present age be B years. Now we are talking of two persons in 3 different times. So let me write like this. That is Jacob, and we are talking of Jacob's son. Jacob's son. We are talking of 3 different times, that is present means now, 5 years ago, and 5 years after. We have already considered Jacob's present age as 8 years and that of his son is 8 years. 5 years ago, that is 5 years back, Jacob's age is 5 years less than the present age, and we can write this as 8 minus 5, and 5 years after, that is after 5 years, Jacob's 5 years is added to Jacob's present age. He will be 5 years more than the present age, and we can write like this A, and we can write like this A plus 5 years. Now, regarding Jacob's son's age, so 5 years ago, like this we can write, 5 years ago, Jacob's son age is 5 years less than his present age, and 5 years after, it is 5 years more than the present age. Now we have set up equations for 2 different timings, and the first sentence tells us 5 years ends, the age of Jacob will be 3 times that of his son. After 5 years, whatever the Jacob's son's age is there, if we multiply that age by 3, that is the age of Jacob. That is, Jacob's age will be 3 times that of his son. So let me write this in equation form. That is, Jacob's age after 5 years will be 3 times three times. The top is son's age after 5 years. Let me simplify this equation and write all the variables in one side of the equation and the constant on the other side. For that, a plus 5 equals, I am multiplying 3 and b, then 3 and 5, it is 3b plus 15. To do further calculation, let me move the canvas. Now, I am going to transfer all the variables on one side of the equation and the constant to the other side of the equation. For this, simultaneously I am adding. To do this, I will move the left hand side little bit left. I am going to move the left hand side little bit left side. Okay. Now I am going to add two quantities on both the sides simultaneously and maintain the equality as it is. I am going to add minus 5 on both the side of the equation as well as minus 3b on both the side of the equation. Now I am going to add the equation. Here plus 5 and minus 5 cancels and I am left with a minus 3b on left side. Here in the right hand side, 3b and minus 3b cancels. Plus 15 and minus 5. If I add plus 15 and minus 5, I am left with plus 10. I call this as equation 1. Okay. Now, I will read the second sentence. For that, I am going to get part the question once again. See, in the second sentence, we have 5 years ago, Jacob's age was 7 times that of his son. That means 5 years ago, the present age, whatever the age of Jacob, it is 5 times that of his son's age. If I multiply the Jacob's son's age by 7, it gives me the age of Jacob. So I will write this in an equation form. Let me write this in an equation form. That is a minus 5 equals the 5 years ago Jacob's age is 7 times that of his son age. That is b minus 5. Like first equation, I am going to write the second equation such that the variables is one side and the constant in the other side of the equation. For this, I am going to simplify the equation. A minus 5 multiply b by 7 and also minus by 5 by 7. It is 7b minus 7 5s are 35. Like in the first equation, if I add the two quantities on both the side, that is plus 5 and minus 7b, like as in the first equation, I will be left with A minus 7B. Since I am adding plus 5 on both the side, that means I am adding here, I am adding plus 5 and minus 7b and minus 7b plus 5. Both the quantities, here 7b and minus 7b cancels, here minus 5 and plus 5 cancels. Here I am left with a and minus 7b. In this side, I am left with minus 35 and plus 5 is minus 30. I call this equation as second equation. Let me solve these two linear equations with the variables A and B to find the age of Jacob and Jacob's sons. For this, I will move the canvas once again. So these two were the equation we got after simplifying these two information. That is A minus 3B equals 10 and A minus 7B equals minus 30. I am going to write these equations once again and I am going to solve for the values A and B. Now I am going to write the second equation right below the first equation. That is, the second equation is A minus 7B equals minus 30. Now I am going to multiply the left hand side and the right hand side of the second equation by minus 1. Then I will add these two equation. Now if you observe, it is plus a and minus a, both cancels. After multiplying by minus 1, the 7b becomes plus 7b. This plus 7b and minus 3b, if you add these two, we are left with plus 4b on the left hand side. Now minus 30 into minus 1 is plus 30. If we add plus 30 and 10, we are going to get plus 40 on the right hand side. Now to get the value of B, divide both the side of the equation by 4. Now 4 cancels and we are left with B on the left side, and 4 tens are 40. The value of B is 10. That is, here the value of B means Jacob's son's present age is 10 years. So now by substituting the value of B in any one of this equation, we will get the value of A, which is nothing but the present age of Jacob's. So for that, I am again writing the first equation here. A minus 3 into, I am going to substitute the substituting the value of B here, that is 10. In the left hand side we have 10. Now after simplifying for A, it is A minus 30 equals 10. Now add plus 30 on both the side of the equation. Here minus 30 and plus 30 cancels. In the left hand side we are left with A equals 40. Here the value of A equals 40 means it is the present age of Jacob. So by getting the values, let me verify the conditions. Here now only we got the age of Jacob, the value of A as 40. It is nothing but the present age of Jacob, that is 40 years. And also we got the value of B as 10, that is the present age of Jacob's son is 10 years. After 5 years, Jacob's age will be 40 plus 5, that is 45. And the age of Jacob's son is 10 plus 5, it is 15. No doubt 45 is the multiple of 15. That is 45 is 3 times 15. So this satisfies the first equation. 5 years ends, the age of Jacob will be 3 times that of his son. The age of Jacob will be 3 times of his son age. Coming back to 5 years ago, that is the Jacob age is 5 years less than the 40. We can write this as 35 years. And that of Jacob's son is 5 less than 10, it is 5 years. So now this satisfies the second sentence, that is 5 years ago, Jacob's age was 7 times that of his son. That is 35 is 7 times 5. Like this, by setting up the given information in the form of pairs of linear equation and solving pairs of linear equation, we arrive at the solution.